the trees to a cliff where Carolina meets the sky. Oh, and there's a view I just can't describe. No, we're not there yet, just a few more steps, baby, wait. Okay, you can open your eyes. This is it, this is now, this is what I've been talking about. Looking out, can't you see forever? Take my hand, just take it in. This is the moment we won't forget. On top of the world here together. If there ever was a time for a perfect kiss, this is it.
Ave My Love, Char. Our forever starts today. Wear this as a symbol of our amulet and endless love. See you later, Nate.
Aww.
Dee, thank you for this gift, and I'm so happy. See you later. I love you.
This sounds crazy, but this could be fate.
Hi, Yuri. Just like this gift, please stick by my side. I can be annoying at times, I can be difficult and stubborn at times, but please, baby, never get tired and never give up. I will cherish you forever. I know you work, and I promise to give you the love you deserve. My love, I love you so much, and I know you know it. Your
brand. Ain't it funny how the time flies? Now you're here as my wife. Remember how you met me? Two hearts on a cold street. Three kids in a big house. Can't believe we're here now. Your warmth has never left me.
I still remember when God tests our love to each other. Remember the moment I told you? I won't get married until I saw you getting married first. And I realize Not all pains are pain. Not all breakups will break you. Your greatest no yesterday might be your greatest yes for today.
For the past 5 years, we share so many amazing experiences full of laughter, excitement, and happiness. I want to let you know that you are my light and my inspirations. I promise to love you forever until the day I die and the rest of eternity.
I promise to help you out every time you will have a lot of things to do in your office and more than willing to act as your personal secretary as well. I can even be your personal driver maybe.
I will respect, be faithful, and honor you always and in all ways with you. I will accept you for who you are today and what you will become. I promise to listen to you, to learn from you, to support, and to let you support me. I promise to help create a family filled with learning, laughter, compassion, and love. I vow to be your man for life. I promise to keep our faith as one of your priorities and grow together with Christ every day. I love you and I can't wait to start calling you Abe Arcilia Ong.
Not sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous, I couldn't speak. In that very moment, I found the one and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live for love, heaven hold you. You look so beautiful in white. And from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Love is timeless, my love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word. So as long as I live alive, so beautiful in white. And from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Ooh, ooh. You look so beautiful in daughter is what our future holds. I hope she has your eyes, finds love like you and I did. Yeah, when she falls in love, we'll let her go. And I won't go down the aisle. She looks so beautiful. So beautiful in white.
Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love, these your servants, Nathanael and Abby, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my own joy may be in you, and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the homily.
Good afternoon, my brothers and sisters. The last part of the Gospel says, love one another as I have loved you. It is because of this love that we are gathered here. It is because of this love that Nathanael and Abby have decided to immortalize this love in the sacrament of matrimony. Let us pray to them that as they live this love in their lives, the two will become one, they will be blessed with children. And those children will grow according to the teachings of our Christian faith. The second, that as they make their love fruitful, they may be faithful to each other. Faithfulness and fidelity, we have to pray for them, that as you journey as a married couple, the Lord Jesus will always be in your midst. Kumbaga, si Abby, si Nathanael, and si Lord Jesus ang third party ninyo. If the Lord Jesus is your third party, then I assure you that things would be easier. I don't promise you that it would be, the journey would be very, very nice. There would be time that there may be worries, problems would come. But if the Lord is within your journey, then things would be easier. The third one is sacrament. So we know that sacrament is an outward sign instituted by Christ that gives grace. Through this sacrament, they will receive the grace that will sanctify their marital union. They will receive the grace that will make them faithful throughout the days of their lives. So my dear parents, as they immortalize this love in the presence of this community before the altar of God, let us pray that they will always be blessed with God's mercy, that we may be able to build a Christian community in our society. Come together so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of Christ and His Church. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated in baptism, and now He enriches and strengthens you by special sacraments so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the Church, may now ask you to answer truthfully the following questions. If did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your husband?
I have.
Nathanael, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your wife?
I have.
Are you both ready to raise as good Christians the children whom God will give you?
I have.
I am.
Nathanael and Abe, since you wish to contract holy matrimony, please join your right hands and express your intention before God and His Church. Abe, do you take Nathanael here present for lawful husband according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I am.
Do you give yourself to him as his wife?
I am.
Do you accept him as your lawful husband?
I am.
Nathanael, do you take Abier present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I am.
Do you give yourself to her as her husband?
I am.
Do you accept her as your lawful wife?
I am.
Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and one soul, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
And I, by the authority of the Church, calling all those present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Nathaniel and Eve sin, we shall now bless your array and rings. Bless, O Lord, your servants, Nathaniel and Eve, with sufficiency of material possessions, which these arrays symbolize, so that they may use them to attain eternal life. Lord, bless these rings and those who wear them. May always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask this through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of a spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts. It's a seal of vows which you, Nathaniel, and Eve have made. Now give these rings to one another.
Abe, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Nathaniel, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I gave you this array as a pledge of my dedication to your welfare, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And I accept them.
My brothers and sisters, may I introduce to you a newly married couple, Nathaniel and Eve. Palakpakan natin sila.
Here's my hand, it's yours to hold. I give myself to you.
Here's my heart, please make it yours. I give my love to you.
We are two becoming one. Here I am, here's all of me. You have all that once was mine.
And here's my promise, I'm yours to hold. I'll stay here by your side.
We are two becoming one. We are two becoming one. May what he's joined me not undone. May our love put Christ on display. When we're weak and when we're strong, when it's hard to carry on, oh God, we want your love on display. We are two becoming one. I lay it down, I give up myself for you.
And here
So we are two becoming one. I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes, we see what we've become. In the cold light of day, we're flaming the wind of the fire we've begun. Every argument, every word we can't take back. Cause with all that has happened, I think that we both know the way that the story ends. Then only for a minute, I want to change my mind, cause this just don't feel right to me. I wanna raise your spirits, I want to see you smile, but no, that means I'll have to leave. No, that means I'll have to leave. Lately, I've been thinking, I want you to be happier, I want you to be happier. When the evening falls and I'm left there.
How does it feel to finally be Mrs. Ong?
Speechless. It's amazing, and I thank God that finally I was able to get married to the man I love.
Beautiful. At syempre, tatanungin natin ang napaka-poging groom. How does it feel to be married to the most beautiful woman tonight?
Great.
A man of few words. Why not?
When you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never loved someone like I do. You probably never loved someone like I do. When you say you love the way I make you feel, everything becomes so real.
We are gathered in this place tonight in spirit of celebration and gratitude. We thank you for the gift of marriage, for all the love and the joy that it brings us. We thank you for the life of my brother Nat and Ace, and for allowing us to witness your faithfulness and your grace upon their lives, and mostly in their love story. We pray that you will bless them with wisdom and inner gifts of trust, compassion, forgiveness, and truth, that they may be able to live out their vows before you and before each other. May all their creations, future creations, be blessed. May we, as their family and friends, be able to commit to encourage and uphold them to the best of our ability. Please bless the food that we are about to receive, and may this reception be an honor to you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Have I told you
Eric Ong, I've been a classmate of Nathaniel Ong since his high school. We are still in high school. I've been his friend since our teenage years, so I can really say that I really know him. He's a good guy and a friend whom you can rely upon in times of your needs. May I request all of you to please rise up and let's have a toast to celebrate the union of Mr. and Mrs. Ong. Okay.
Cheers! Cheers.
Congratulations and God bless.
Everyone, good evening. I'm truly glad to have witnessed the union of my friend, to be able to find someone to love and share your life with. It's been an honor to be here. In 1 Corinthians 13, Paul says that even he gives all his possession to the poor and gave his body to hardships, but don't have love, he gains nothing. What's love then? We heard before that from Eve, they truly love one another. So, he gives this definition. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. So, wala na pong mga listahan. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Ayan, huwag niyong tingnan yung katabi ninyo. I'm already persevering. Love never fails. And now, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of all is love. Having to find someone and be your partner for the rest of your life is truly amazing. We praise God for this union. Continue to love one another. We implore God Almighty to bless you and guide your family. Again, congratulations to the both of you.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Ong. Hi. I am Ariane, by the way, and I am a friend of Ave. Yeah. I've known Ave since 2015. Well, not long enough. But the time we met is just a perfect timing that God has introduced us with each other. I've met Ave when I was so in love with my ex-boyfriend, which is now my husband. I've met her at the time when I was so in love, while she was really, really broken. We live in the same apartment, same room, here in Manila. And I must say that I am a living witness of Ave's love for Nate. I see her crying every day and every night. I honestly don't know how to approach her. Well, because at first she looks really, really suplada. So I waited for like a week and just wait until she talks to me first. Kasi nga, every time I try to talk to her after my work, I see her mostly on her bed, crying, sleeping. And what's awkward about it is that she reads the Bible all the time na nakikita ko siyang hindi umiiyak. So it's really weird for me because I don't read Bible as much as her. So she also has that attitude that before I go to work and leave her alone in our room, she would tell me, "Dai, huwag mo i-close yung light, Dai." Ang weird, di ba? Well, then weeks after that, I see her na hindi na masyadong umiiyak. I see her na nag-aayos na siya ng closet niya or nag-ready na kasi maglalaban na siya, ganun. At that point, kinapalan ko na yung mukha ko. And I ask her, "What was your name? What is your age? Etc. Anything about her?" But I never asked the reason why is she crying all the time. Then few days after we started talking with each other, doon na siya nag-open about Nathaniel. Noong unang pinakita sa akin ni Ave yung picture ni Nath, sabi ko agad, "Ba't kaya naghiwalay? Nababae yan, no?" Sorry, Nath. Well. Then she told me na, hindi. Hindi yun yung dahilan. Well, she describes Nath as a very responsible boyfriend. She describes Nath as a very responsible son to his parents. He's super effort nga daw in everything, as mentioned by her. Still, she never told me the reason why the two of them broke up. But I was able to ask her why she doesn't want me to close the light when I leave. She just said, "Pag madilim na yung paligid, nalulungkot ako. Iiyak na naman ako." So days, weeks, and months have passed by. I have to move out from our apartment kasi I was also busy arranging my wedding then. From then, di pa rin naputol yung friendship hanggang sa nalaman ko sila na ulit ni Nit. Sobrang, sobrang saya ko. Pakiramdam ko ako yung magulang ni Abe. Kasi before I move out, I told her na, "Dai." Kasi yung tawag niya sa akin na, "Dai, Dai." Hindi ako Bisaya, pero Dai ang tawag niya sa akin. Ewan ko bakit. Sabi niya, "Dai, para talaga kayo yung..." Sabi ko sa kanya, "Dai, para talaga kayo yung Nate na yan sa isa't isa." Ang sagot niya lang lagi sa akin, "Sana nga." At yung sana na yun, eh ito na pala yung simula. To my dearest friend, Abe, bago ako ikasal, sinasabi mo sa akin lagi na masaya ka para sa akin. This time, ibabalik ko naman sa'yo.
Para akong magulang mo tuloy.
Sobrang happy ako para sa'yo. Totoo yung famous na kasabihan na if it's meant to be, it will be. Tsaka yung in God's perfect time. Lahat yan nagkatotoo sa'yo, sa inyong dalawa. Well, I wish you all the best. May God continuously shower you and your marriage with so much blessings. I love you, Abe. I love you, Nate. Nabagdag ka na. So, congratulations. Thank you.
Okay, ready? O yung maswaki pa. Okay, wait lang, sir.
In 3, 2, 1, go!
Couple number 1, couple number 2, couple number 3.
joke lang, joke lang. Ayun, may nahanap. Couple number 6 right here. Uy, couple number 7. Closer muna. Picture muna tayo, group shot. Si Nate sa labas. Sabi nila, David, hindi ko alam kung sinong mananalo mamaya sa singles. Pero lucky number kasi sa amin ang I Love You Very Much. Number 5. Couple number 5 right here. Everybody else may take their seats. Couple number 5 is right here. Rachel, how are you doing today?
I'm doing good.
How do you feel na ikaw ang napili dito sa harap?
Overwhelmed.
Happy pa naman?
Oh, happy.
Yee! Rachel, may boyfriend ka? Ala, nag-isip! Kinalimutan na yung boyfriend. Pogi mo kasi. Meron wala?
Friend.
May friend ka, pero wala pang boyfriend. Okay, palakpakan para kay Rachel. And of course, let's get to know the future groom. His name is?
Arnel.
Arnel, sa lahat ng mga babae tonight, bakit si Rachel ang napili natin?
Nag-ask kasi ako kay Abe ng kung sino yung single.
Nag-ask ka kay Abe kung sino yung single. Tapos tinuro ni Abe si Rachel. Ang hindi mo alam, plinano namin lahat yun. Okay? Pero, may girlfriend ka ba?
Meron!
Nandito ba siya? Wala naman siya. Okay lang, wala namang camera. Tayo-tayo lang. Okay? Game lang naman to. Arnel and Rachel, the first thing we're going to do is a mirror game. I'm the mirror right here at the center. Isa po akong salamin. Kung ano pong ipapagawa ko kay Nate at Abe, gagayahin ni Rachel at ni Arnel. Eksaktong eksakto. Una nating papagawa, ladies first, Abe. O, tingin ka Rachel ha. Nakasimangot na si Rachel kay Abe. Sabi, humanda ka mamaya. Abe, mamili ka ng parte sa katawan ni Nate na gusto mong halikan. At hahalikan mo to in 3... 2, 1! Oo. Akala niya sa lips na eh. Sabi niya, wait lang. Asan yun? Ah, dito lang. Sa ear lang. Sa ear lang. Okay, ready? Get set. Go! Ayun, palakpakan. Game na game. Okay, next natin. The gentleman, Nate. Arnel, observe Nate very carefully. Nate, mamili ka ng parte ni Rachel na gusto mong halikan at ahalikan mo to in 3, 2, 1. Oh, okay. Rachel, bakit kinikilig ka? Tawang-tawa ka or laki kinikilig ka? Asa kinikilig ka sa kanila? Oh, Arnel, laki na ng butil ng pawis natin. Wala namang camera, tayo-tayo lang. Dito lang sa jaw. Okay, dito. Wala naman sa cheek. Dito lang sa jaw. Okay, dito. Ready, Arnel? 3, 2, 1, go! Palakpakan! Last natin gagawin. Abe and Nate, nose to nose tayo ng tatlo. Okay, ready? Get set? Go! 1, 2, 3! Okay, dito na tayo. Yee, kinikilig si Rachel! Alright, ready? Get set? Go! 1, 2, 3! Palakpakan! Alright, tayo tayo, Arnel, dito ka. And Nate, dito ka sa kabila. Underneath the bride's gown, she's wearing a garter. Tatanggalin po yan ni Nate. Okay? Pag natanggal niya, ibibigay niya kay Arnel at Arnel, isusuot mo kay Rachel. Now, para mas malaman mo kung paano gagawin, uunahin natin si Nate muna. Observe ka muna, okay? Now, Nate, para naman at least challenging yung gagawin natin. Para ang dali-dali lang naman magtanggal ng garter. Kaya naman, habang papalapit ka sa bride mo, pwede pang makakita ng isang sexy dance! 3, 2, 1!
Koy sa'yo, ikaw ay akin.
Yun na daw sexy para kay Nate eh. Ayun, ang lambot nga naman talaga ng katawan. Oh, wala pa. More. Iyo.
Kung ngayon nag-iisa.
Konti pa. Parang masakit yung balakang mo ah.
Sana ay tabihan.
At unti-unti siyang luluhod.
Sa ilalim ng
Flying Eagle tayo ah.
usapin ng ating groom, ang Garter. Raise it in the air, wave it for me, Nate. Taas-taas, palakpakan para sa ating groom. At ibibigay niya kay Arnel. Arnel, namumula ka na. Arnel, syempre nakita mo ang galing-galing ni Nate sumayaw kahit pa ganun-ganun lang yun, pero nag-effort. Kaya naman, gusto niyo bang makita si Arnel sumayaw? Before niya isusuot kay Rachel ang garter, sa siya'y sasayaw ng sexy dance. 3, 2, 1, go! Ayan na! Ang galing-galing naman pala ni Arnel. Magbato-bato, pick! Okay, nasa angle na. Do you want it higher or lower? Sabi ni Bride, higher daw. Sabi ni Rachel, grabe ko. Konting-konti lang. Ayan sa tuhod na. Palakpakan, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Arnel and Rachel. We have the bride and groom. The union of two families. That is why it is only right to hear a message from both sides of the family, from the groom's side and the bride's side. From the groom's side, we have the groom's brother, Oliver Ong. A big hand, please.
Hello. Good evening. I'm Oliver. I'm the eldest brother of Nathaniel. We call him Kirby at home, and I'm his aya. Kuya for Chinese term, no? I want to start by congratulating the bride and groom and thanking all of you for coming here today. Okay, my kumbaga konting introduction, no, para at least makilala niyo si Nat. No, my parents and I love him from the day he was born. Siyang bunsong lalaki, and we call him Shoti in Chinese. So, tatlo kami. So, I'm the oldest, siya yung pangalawa, si Kirby, and then dyan si Giselle, yung pinaka youngest sister, no? So, nung bata pa kami, Kirby and I were buddies. We always do things together. We like nung bata pa, playing action figures, alam mo na, mga video games. Siya yung kalaro ko, no? As I recall, during our teenage years, every Sunday, around 6 a.m., we usually bike here sa CCP, Luneta, from our house pa sa Binondo, no? Kirby loves to play billiards. I'm always his playing opponent. He also likes to play bowling. Kaya lang, lagi akong talo sa kanya. So, magaling siya mag-bowling kaysa sa akin. So, sa house, siya yung pinaka-MacGyver namin. I believe, kilala nyo pa yung MacGyver. Pero sa mga millennials, baka hindi na. So, siya gumagawa lahat ng mga problem sa bahay. Kunyari, may sirang ganito, sirang appliances. So, tinatry niyang i-figure out para maayos. Good thing na ayos naman. Mga 80% nagagawa. 20 nasisira. No, joke lang. So, dahil sa sobrang idol niya yun, meron rin siyang sariling Swiss knife. So, meron siya mga collection yan, kung ano-anong Swiss knife, kung anong combination. So, laging meron yan sa pocket niya. Ewan ko lang kung dala niya ngayon. Wala. So, dahil halos magkalapit kami ng age, ang nakakatuwa rito, naghihiraman kami ng mga damit. So, sapatos, at kung ano-ano pa, relos, ganyan, so, slacks. So, sa ngayon, hiniram ko ngayon sapatos niya. Sa kanya to, dito sa akin. So, yun yung good thing about having a brother, no? Na, kumbaga, anytime pwede kaming mag, you know, exchange ng mga damit, ano? Tsaka kung ano ng mga gamit. As we grow older, Kirby decided to go to China, sa Shenzhen, and work there for a couple of years. Well, I'm proud of him that he were able to face the challenges overseas and naging mature siya doon as an individual, no? Now, as you will face another milestone in your life, which is, yan, marriage, always remember that together with the rest of our family, we are here to support you. Ave, I want you to know how blessed you are to have a husband like Kirby. He is a good man, a very hardworking person, and I know he will be a responsible husband as well. sabi sa Bible in Proverbs 18 verse 22, he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. I believe that you're gonna have a wonderful adventure ahead of you, and with God's blessing, may you overcome all the obstacles and challenges you're gonna face throughout your marriage life. If there's anything you need, I'm just a phone call away. Phone call lang, ah. So, pero seriously, your Anya will always be here for you to help and support you. Congratulations to both of you, and we love you, and we wish you all the best in life and the years to come. So, cheers.
Thank you very much, Oliver Ong. That was...
So, like, my sister actually asked me, like, a few months back, she told me to prepare, like, an hour talk. So, I actually prepared not a lot, but 4 pages, I think. So bear with me, please. So I'm just gonna read it. Okay. I'm so scared. Okay. If we look into the Merriam-Webster dictionary, worst is superlative of bad. It means corrupt, evil, most unfavorable, most unsuitable. Ate, tabid, tabidling, bid. Asuncion, Ave Puyat Arcelia, and now Mrs. Ong. You're the worst sister I've ever known in this universe, truly. Worst, though, doesn't mean the definition that I just, like, said. Of course, worst doesn't only mean bad things. Like, there is opposition in all things, like good, evil, and in English, like, same sounds, the same spelling but different in meaning. What do you call that? Homonyms, shall we say. Like bear, like animals, or like hold on. It also means like that, right? And can, like able, or it's, we can also call it like the container, like this, like Mountain Dew. So it's a can. So for me, ate, you are the worst. Witty, obedient, responsible, sweet, and thoughtful. Witty, like you're intelligent. When we were young, you thought free panda cell from playing badminton could make our tummy full for merienda. Not just that. Joining the badminton team truly sufficed your feeling of being deeply in love for your crush. Wasn't that a brilliant idea? Obedient to the sense of honoring our parents. I truly admire you for that. And you're a type of daughter na ba-ba lang kung ba-ba. Bibig kung bibig dito, dyan. Like, yaw-yaw diri, yaw-yaw dito, yaw-yaw everywhere. But yeah, as you mentioned, if we obey, we will be blessed. You said, Mona, just shut your mouth. Obey and you'll be blessed. Responsible. I could say I grew up with you. You're not just my sister, but also my brother. Like the Bisrock songs, and like Tumboyon Ka, like the Sabong, the Trompo, the Kaka, whatsoever, the spider, like the fighting, the spider, something like that. But most especially, you're my mother and father when our parents were busy at work. I could say that those times I've learned the struggles from you, But you learned, known, and felt those struggles. Ang kalisod sa kinabuhi. I can't measure how you've grown from those experiences. But I'm so proud of you that you remain strong and immovable until now. Sweet and thoughtful. I thought that if you go on dates with your text mate, you would forget me. I still remember when you went on dates, you would always ask me to ask permission to Papa in your behalf. But you never failed me. Every time you came home from your dates, I always have waffle time, like always cheese flavor. Or Jollibee, like the spaghetti, I really love it. And remember the Barbie doll, the one that's the first like ever gift that I received from anyone else. I truly cherish it a lot. You told me in this exact same word, and I quote, Mona, never go on dates with boys who have a dirty nails, who has a dirty nails. Because men like them are so untidy, not just an appearance, but on how they deal with their lives. Grabe gud akong ate, no? So for sure, Kuya Nate, na dyan siya limpyo na, Coco. She's really like, he has clean nails for sure. So, ate, those are the worst of you. Those were some memories that I had with you that I cherished the most. Ate, remember that you are always the worst sister to me. And now that you enter this journey to be a helpmeet and a companion to Kuya Nate, ate, be the worst wife. I didn't mean that you need to be witty, obedient, responsible, sweet, and thoughtful too. Of course, you already possess those qualities. A worst wife, I mean, is a woman who obey, respect, who's submissive and teachable with her spouse to Nate. With your spouse. To end this talk, I would like to share a simple advice thought by William Hunter on how to make each other happy. He said that. So, Kuya Nate, so ate, you only need to do like 5 things to make Kuya Nate happy. First, feed him, sleep with him, leave him with peace. Don't always check his phone. Don't bother him with his movements. So, what's hard with that, diba? So, Kuya Nate, let's see. There are 53 things how to make ate happy. It's not really difficult, but to make a woman happy, you only need to be a friend, a companion, a lover, a brother, a father, a master, a chef, an electrician, a plumber, a mechanic, a carpenter, a decorator, a stylist, a sexologist, a gynecologist, psychologist, pest exterminator, psychiatrist, healer, good listener, good father, very clean, an organizer, sympathetic, athletic, warm, attentive, gallant, intelligent, funny, creative, tender, strong, understanding, tolerant, prudent, ambitious, capable, courageous, determined, true, dependable, passionate. Without forgetting to give her compliments regularly, go shopping with her, be honest, not stress her out, not look at her other girls. At the same time, you must also give her lots of attention. But most of all, it is very important, Kuya. It's very important. Never forget birthdays, anniversaries, Valentine's, and arrangements she makes. Okay, maglagot siya. She'll get mad so much. And that's all. I love you both. Save the best for tonight.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank God for being you here, guys. In our big day. on behalf of Miss Abe and I, we would like to thank our parents, Mr. and Mrs. Arcelia, Mr. and Mrs. Ong Kim Leong. oh yeah, kaya ko to. for our parents, for Miss Abe parents, we promise we will going to visit you yearly in Cebu, despite of kahit na kano kami kabusy, Yeah. And for my parents, we promise na you will no longer buy foods every Sunday. Yeah, we will cook food for you. Yeah. And for the my friends from China, from Canada, Mr. Villapando family. Yeah, thank you for coming here. We appreciate your good effort. Although we know that it is very far from Philippines. Yeah. Mm. And also to friends from, you know, high school friends. Yeah. And to friends of A. Barcelia, the office mates, Saital family. Thank you.
Best friend.
Best friends. And, you know, cousins, relatives, and to Golchao family. Yeah, thank you. And to my ninong ninang. Hey, thank you. I hope you have a blast here in our big day. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Maybe we could hear a few words from the lovely bride. A big hand, please.
I just want to say thank you for everyone who stays with us up until the end of the program. Both I and Nathaniel are really appreciate the effort of coming here to celebrate this wonderful day for the start of our journey. So thank you very much for coming, and God bless everyone. Take care.
Mabuhay ang bagong kasal! Ave and Nate, congratulations. May God bless you with a wonderful life together. Ladies and gentlemen, although this program has ended here, the night is not yet over. We're going to play more music so that you can spend time with the couple. Come forward, have pictures with them. You may dance if you want to. Enjoy the rest of the night. My name is David Mercado. God bless us all and good evening.